A friend asked me if a bodhisattva, after passing the first bhumi, can again fall into samsara.
No, you know, as far as I know, a bodhisattva on the first bhumi cannot retrogress. No, so we are now talking about the first bhumi attained by self power. Okay, so if yes. This is the first bhumi is called. Is called pramudita. It's called very joyous, very joyous, to have a lot of joy, mm-hmm. and it is the stage of no retrogression actually. So a bodhisattva who really attains the first bhumi cannot retrogress. Then he will advance to the next bhumis, but the time in which he will advance to the next bhumis might be longer or shorter. I don't know. It depends on that bodhisattva. So we are now talking here about a bodhisattva in aspiration, because there are two types of bodhisattvas. One is enlightened bodhisattvas, that is bodhisattvas who already attained enlightenment and continue to manifest in samsara in various ways, even pretending to not be enlightened. And I explained this when I in my commentary on the larger sutra. Chapter 2, I think. And then we have bodhisattvas in aspiration, bodhisattva who aspire to become a Buddha for himself and all beings. And these are not enlightened bodhisattvas. They have to advance through the these 10 bhumis. So when they enter the first bhumi, that is no retrogression. And we who entrust to Amida Buddha also enter the stage of no retrogression. But unlike a bodhisattva on the self-power path, who has to advance through the other 9 stages in a long time, we reach complete Buddhahood at the end of our illusory body, as you know, when we enter the Pure Land. Okay, so we enter the stage of no retrogression in this life, and when we entrust for the first time in Amida Buddha, and then in the moment of death, we enter the Pure Land and we go instantaneously through all the 9 stages and attain complete Buddhahood in that same moment. That's the beauty
okay.
for us.
Yes. Yes. Okay. Thank you.
We are also, our masters also speak about joy, the joy of faith, which is similar with this first bhumi, which is called also very joyous. So this, the joy of faith means that we feel like we realize that a great burden was taken from us, the burden of attaining liberation. And we are like, we are assured of enlightenment, you know. It doesn't mean that we always jump with joy, always 24/7. But we have this, I don't know, this serenity, this joy that we know we are safe. So it's somehow the same. Somehow we attain the same stage with those bodhisattvas who struggle so hard through personal practices. We attain the same stage through the help of Amida. Yes. And
Sensei,
please.
We are bodhisattvas in aspiration in this world.
Yes.
The only hope is the aspiration of the attained Buddhahood in the Pure Land of Amida.
Yes.
It's okay.
You can say that
Bhumi is not self-power.
Yes, we cannot speak about Bhumis in our case.
Okay. Yes. See, no bhumis for us.
yes, but of course there might be very advanced bodhisattvas on the fourth bhumi or the fifth bhumi or the tenth bhumi who might hear about the teaching of Amida salvation And he can also have faith in Amida. But then he goes to the Pure Land, you know? So the primal vow of Amida Buddha is made for all beings, not only for the lowest of the low, like us, but also for the bodhisattvas, for the highly advanced bodhisattvas. They can too entrust to Amida Buddha. They are not excluded from the primal vow because they reached a certain bhumi through self-power. If they admit the futility of the self of the self-power effort and entrust to Amida, then it's easier for them too to reach the Pure Land and enlightenment. You know? And
yes.
And actually, many Buddhas in various universes teach the bodhisattvas the in aspiration in their assembly to go and visit the Pure Land of Amida or to hear, they invite them to hear and accept the teaching of Amida Buddha, you know? And if they do that, that's very helpful for them also.
Yes. Okay. Thank you, Sensei.
You are welcome.